Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I thought it would be a good idea to do a what's on my iPhone video. I just redid my home screen because of the new iOS update, and I've never done a what's on my iPhone before, and I love watching these videos. I really like them because I love to see like the apps that other people use. It gives me like good ideas of like cool things. I also like to see how like other people have set up their phones and everything, and I thought just with like the new update this would be like perfect. So first off, I have the iPhone 7 Plus. This is just the case that I have on it. It's just like a pink spec case. My phone is the rose gold color. I do need to get a new case because this one's like breaking and stuff. Like, this is like my very first case that I got when I got this phone a couple years ago, and I just have left it on because I just like it because it's protective and everything. So yeah, but I'm gonna start screen recording so that I can show you guys what is on my phone. Okay, so basically this is like my lock screen. It's just a picture of my boyfriend and I. So this is my first like page. At the top, this is a widget. This is from the app Color Widgets. It's like all of these, like it has the time and the date and stuff on it. And you can like customize yours. Like you can, this is like the one that I have on right now. You can like customize it and make them like different colors. You can make them darker, lighter. You can do whatever you want. I really like it. It's like really nice and customizable. And then, so basically like my first page of apps is just like all the ones that come with the phone, like the FaceTime, calendar, photos, camera, all that stuff. And then I have like the extra folder of just like all the other apps that come with the phone that I don't use. Then I have this one that I just labeled like a couple smiley faces. And this one has photo widgets, color widgets, the game 2048, a Canon app for my camera, a symbol keyboard, and then Get Mobile, which that's just like an app that I have for college. And then all the apps like in the bottom, I just have like Messenger and the phone and Safari and Music. Okay, so this is my first like page of apps. I have like a widget picture up in the corner of my boyfriend and I again. Then I have Instagram. If you guys want to follow me on Instagram, it's AdelineRose18. And then I have Snapchat, TikTok. If you want to follow me on TikTok, AdelineRose18 again. Then I have Facebook, and then I have Visco. If you guys want to follow me on Visco, it's my username is also AdelineRose18, I'm pretty sure. Then I just have my favorite Bible verse, which is "The Lord is on my side, I will not fear," which is Psalm 119:6. I just really like it. And then in the bottom, it's just a picture of my sister and I. Also, my home screen is just this picture. I thought it was super cute. I don't know. I found it on Pinterest, and it's just like these cute little like green dinosaurs with a pink background. And I thought it was just kind of like nice and like neutral to like go with everything. So my next page is all of like my blue apps. So like basically the first page is just like social media stuff and like a few pictures, like kind of randomish. And then all my other pages are like color coded. So this one is blue. So I just have a little like flower picture. Then I have Twitter, Messenger, Best Fiends, which this game is amazing. It was super popular, and like I feel like every single YouTuber was like, "This video is sponsored by Best Fiends." Like, I feel like it was super popular a while ago, and I just got back into it. It's so much fun. I literally play it more than I should. Then I have Outlook, which is just my email for my school. Then I have a widget for the weather. Then I have a countdown app, GroupMe, which is also for school, Blackboard, which is for school, Disney Plus app, and then WidgetSmith. Which, all of, like, the custom widgets that I have that have pictures are made from WidgetSmith. And at the end of the video, I'll show you guys how to make your own because it was really confusing. So I'll show you how to do that at the end of the video because I know you guys will probably want to know how to make, like, your own. All right, my next page is just like red. So I have my YouTube app, YouTube Studio, Pinterest, Netflix. Then I just have like a rose picture. Then I have a good vibes picture. And then I have my chart, which is just something through like Bassett Healthcare, if you know what that is, just like to contact your doctor. And then I have my love. And then down here, I just have like my screen time. As you can see, I spent 33 minutes on Widget Smith because this morning I was playing around with my, I actually did my home screens and stuff this morning, so that's why I was on it for that long. I might not leave this here. I don't really know how I feel about it yet. Let me know in the comments below if you think that I should keep this or just get rid of it. Then my last one is green, and then at the top I just have like a star green widget. Then I have Spotify, Hulu, my Cricut, this other like app for school, Bitmoji, and then I have this quote that says, "Don't worry about the things you can't control." So I have that. And then if you slide over one more, this is just like the app library. Whoopsies. And this is just has like all your apps that are like categorized for you. I don't really like ever go and use this. I don't know, but it's kind of cool, I guess, if you're looking, if you can't like find an app and you're like, okay, it's a social media app. You can just go into your social and then it will show like all of your social media stuff. So I do like that aspect of it. Okay, so now I'm going to show you guys how to make your own custom widgets. So I also tried using the app Photo Widget as well, and it didn't work as well. I couldn't figure it out, but some people use that. So Widget Smith, this is basically just what it looks like when you like go into it. It just has like all the widgets that I've already made. So I'm gonna show you guys how to make your own. So basically you can use an app from your photos, or you can use an app off of Pinterest, and I'm just gonna find an app off of Pinterest. I'll just click like pink aesthetic. Oh yeah, that's what I did too for all of my other pictures that weren't like from my camera roll. Like if you want to customize your pages, like I did by color, like for the blue page, I just did like blue aesthetic. Or yeah, but I go into Pinterest and Pinterest has like so many things. So I'll just do like this Be Kind thing. I think it's cute. So then I just click the three red dots in the bottom of the screen, and then you click download image, and what that's gonna do is it's just gonna download it into your photos. So then we're gonna go over to our photos and click on it. Then you wanna click like the little like arrow thing and click add to album. Then you wanna click a new album, and you can just label it. I'll just label it like W12, I don't know, any random one that you want. Also, something that you need to do is go into your settings, and you need to make sure that go to the Widget Smith app, and if you go to the photos, you want to make sure that all photos are selected. When I had a lot of trouble with it, and I first did selected photos, and everything like got messed up, you want to make sure you click all photos, because that's going to show you all of your photo albums. Then you go back into Widget Smith, and you can pick the size of the widget that you want. So I'll just do like a small one, and it's gonna automatically come up with one. So you just click on it and then click on it again, and then you scroll down all the way to the bottom, and it's gonna show photos. And then I'm gonna go, as you can see, like these are like all my other ones. And then you go to click on W12 and then click back, and then it will like show up and you can see it. And then you click save, and then it will save it. Then you're just gonna go back to your screen and hold it, and then click the plus at the top. Then you scroll all the way down on your widget like thing to add a widget. Then you go to Widget Smith, and then you click, because we picked the small size, click add widget. It's gonna come up a gray box, but you're gonna wanna click on it, and you're gonna see all of these small widgets that you've made, and ours is the 8th one. And then you just click it, and then it will go just like that. And that is how you make the widget. Hopefully that wasn't too confusing. I think that's pretty much it for everything that is on my iPhone. I am really happy with the update. I love the widgets. I just love how you can add more things onto your screen, specifically pictures, because with all the other like iOS's, the only pictures that you could really have were like your lock screen photo and your home screen photo. So I like how you can add more to it. I just really love the widgets. Like, I just think they're so cool. I don't know. Basically, that is it for my what's on my iPhone. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. That would mean so much to me. Also, if you are not subscribed, please go ahead and click that subscribe button in the description box, and also click the bell to get notified for every time that I upload a video, which is usually Saturdays at 3 o'clock. I've been super proud of myself because I feel like I've been staying pretty consistent with like uploading, so I've just been proud of myself about that. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed and have an amazing day. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.